Karthike Bhargav.
Hello, my name is Mohammad Saad Rashid. We are BTech second year students from Electronics and Communication branch of BIT University, Vellore.
We are here to talk about a project, Life Sensor, which is a cost efficient and easy to install way to measure the number of people that are entering and exiting any room of any building at any point of time.
Not just it counts the number of people present in an environment, it also measures the local parameters and in a required situation sends the data to the local authorities.
It keeps the privacy intact because we've used ultrasound and IR sensors and not image processing cameras. It does not breach any privacy of any person. In Module X, we've used a combination of IR sensors, PIR motion sensor and ultrasonic range finder to accurately measure the amount of people that are entering and exiting a building at any point of time. The placement of these sensors at the gates help differentiate between objects and live human beings.
After Module X, we come to Module Y. Module Y comprises of the MSV430 launch pad provided by Texas Instruments as part of the competition. It also has the LM35 temperature sensor also provided by Texas Instruments. Module Y has three very important functions to carry out. Number one, it processes the data sent by Module X. Number two, it measures the local parameters. And number three, it transmits the data to Module Z.
After Module Y, we have Module Z, which consists of three major components, the BeagleBone Black and the Multiplexer IC, both of which are provided to us by Texas Instruments, and GSM900A module. The BeagleBone Black is a single board computer which has two 32-bit ARM microprocessors, which will help us in the large data analysis of the data that is collected from all the rooms and sent to us by the Multiplexer IC. The GSM900A module will help transmit this data to the concerned authorities in the case of an emergency.
Coming to the system, this over here is the PIR motion sensor interface with the MSP along with the ultrasonic and the IR sensors, where the count will be displayed on the LCD.
The prototype made is a working model for one room. The system can be applied to all rooms in a corporate building. Here, we see that the data from the X module is transferred to the Y module, where it is processed and sent to the Z module. In case of an emergency, the Z module will transmit this data wirelessly to the concerned authorities. These are few slides explaining the transfer of data from all rooms. The impact of this system is large. The data can help the authorities carry out a smart rescue operation in case of an emergency, for example, a fire, and it can save millions of lives. Using data like this, the temperature of the room and the number of people who were present in the room before the calamity occurred, can help the authorities carry out the operation accordingly.
Future prospects. The system can be integrated with the present technology of home automation and security. With the latest development and concepts such as the Internet of Things, the data from the system can be synced with the cloud and can be securely accessed by the authorities concerned. Just using the current hardware, the data can also be uploaded on the cloud. We see the system becoming a standard of security in the developing countries due to its affordability and its ease of installation.